Okay, to recapitulate what we did in the last session was distance and displacement. We defined distance as the total path length covered by an object and displacement as the shortest path between the initial and final position. Distance is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. Distance is always positive and displacement can be positive, negative or zero. We did a few examples also to understand this. And lastly, distance is greater or equal to displacement in all cases, or and displacement is less or equal to distance in all cases. And we had also given an example where distance and displacement are equal, that is when an object moves in a straight line. To proceed with now, once we have defined distance and displacement, we are going to learn about speed and velocity. Speed, as we have already defined in class 7th also, it is a physical quantity which is calculated as distance covered by an object per unit time. Numerically, it is written as distance upon time. The SI unit for speed is meters per second. It is also written as meter per second like this. Since speed is calculated using distance and time, it is also a scalar quantity. We will do a few numericals also to emphasize on this formula. One simple numerical, just to recapitulate the formula. Suppose an object covers a distance of 50 meters in 5 seconds. And you are asked to calculate the speed of the object. So how do we calculate? We simply put the values in the formula which says speed is distance upon time. When we put the values, we get the answer as 10 meter per second. Don't forget the units. Okay, so this was speed. Similarly, we have another physical quantity which is velocity. Velocity is defined as displacement covered by the object in a given interval of time. So speed was distance upon time, velocity is displacement upon time. In simple language, velocity is also known as speed with direction, and that is the reason why velocity is a vector quantity. Since displacement is measured in meters, time is measured in seconds, the SI unit for velocity is also meter per second. So how is it different from speed is that it is speed with direction. That would mean if I say an object is traveling at 50 meter per second, I have described its speed. But if I say the object is traveling with 50 meter per second towards east, this is velocity, speed with direction. Now, once we have defined speed and velocity, we will be defining uniform and non-uniform motion. Again, uniform and non-uniform motion, you are familiar with the term since class 7th. An object is said to be in uniform motion if it covers equal distances in equal intervals of time. Suppose an object is covering say 2 meters in every 1 second. So the object is covering equal distances in equal intervals of time. We say the object is in uniform motion. That means the speed is fixed. What is the speed in this case? It is 2 meter per second. 2 meters every second the object is covering. So, uniform motion, equal distances are covered in equal intervals of time. On the contrary, non-uniform motion would be unequal distances in equal interval of time. If the object is covering unequal distances in equal intervals of time. Suppose, this is the case. the scale is in meters, and suppose the object is covering these unequal distances in interval of 1 second every time. So this time, suppose in the first 1 second object is covering 1 meter, in the next 1 second only half a meter, in the next 1 second more than 1.5 meters, and so on. So the speed is not constant, we call it non-uniform motion. Unequal distances are being covered in equal intervals of time, non-uniform motion. In such cases, to describe the motion, we require a physical quantity known as average speed, because this time the speed is not fixed. So for non-uniform motion, we require this form of speed known as average speed. Average speed is defined as total distance covered by the object divided by total time taken to cover that distance. Normally we define speed as distance upon time, but when it is non-uniform motion, average speed is defined as total distance upon total time. We'll do a few numericals again.
Okay, so this is the first numerical on average speed. An object covers 20 meters in 4 seconds and the next 20 meters in 6 seconds. You have to calculate the average speed of the object. So the formula for average speed is total distance upon total time. We put the values. Total distance is 20 plus 20, that would be 40, and total time would be 4 plus 6, that is 10 seconds. And when we calculate the average speed, it comes out to be 4 meter per second. So total distance, that is adding both the distances, and total time is adding the time taken in both the halves, and we get the average speed. So this is the second example. Example 8.1 from page 101 of your NCERT. It says that an object covers first 16 meters in 4 seconds and the next 16 meters in 2 seconds. You have to calculate the average speed of the object. So average speed is total distance upon total time. So total distance in this case is 16 plus 16. So that is 32 meters. And total time here is 4 plus 2. That is 6 seconds. So 32 by 6, which will come out to be 5.33 meter per second. This is a non-terminating decimal, but we'll leave it at the second place. So total distance, that is sum of these two distances, 16 plus 16, 32, and total time is sum of these two different time slots, 4 plus 2, that is 6. So total distance upon total time, 32 by 6, that is 5.33 meter per second.
Okay, so example 8.3 from your NCERT, page 102. It says that a person swims along a 90 meter long pool and comes back in 1 minute. 90 meter long pool, the person swims along the length and comes back in 1 minute. That means 180 meters are being covered in 1 minute. You have to find the average speed and average velocity for the same case. Now, average speed we have defined as distance upon time or total distance upon total time. And average velocity is total displacement upon total time. So, total distance travelled here would be 90 meter going along the length and 90 meter swimming back. So, 90 plus 90, that will be 180 meters. So, distance, total distance covered by the person is 180 meters. And total time taken by the person is 1 minute. In SI unit, this would be 60 seconds. So average speed is total distance, that is 180 meter, divided by total time, that is 60 seconds. 180 by 60, this comes out to be 3 meters per second. So the average speed of the swimmer is 3 meter per second. On the other hand, average velocity, which is calculated as displacement per unit time. In this case, the person is swimming from a point, swimming along the length and then coming back to the same point. So, initial position and the final position of the object is the same. So, in this case, the displacement of the swimmer is 0. And the time taken is the same, that is 60 seconds. So, since displacement throughout the swim is 0. The average velocity in this case is also 0 meter per second. So this is another example which gives you the distinction between speed and velocity. In this case, since the swimmer has come back to the same place, average velocity is 0 because the displacement is 0. But distance can never be 0. It is always positive. It is only added. The going length and the coming back length is being added. So average speed is coming out to be 3 meters per second. So as I said, this example emphasizes on the difference between speed and velocity. Next, moving on.
So similar to distance and displacement, we will differentiate between speed and velocity also. Distance upon time, that is what we define speed as. And velocity is displacement upon time. So that is the first difference between them. Speed is distance upon time, velocity is displacement upon time. Since distance is a scalar, speed is also a scalar quantity. And displacement being a vector, velocity is also a vector quantity. Speed is always positive, but velocity can be positive, negative, and zero. As we had discussed, displacement can be positive, negative, or zero. Hence, velocity can also be positive, negative, or zero. So, similar to distance and displacement, the differences between speed and velocity are stated. Okay, students. So, in this chapter, till now, we have discussed physical quantities as scalars and vectors. We defined distance, displacement. We differentiated among the two with the help of numericals also. We defined speed, velocity. We differentiated between the two with the help of numericals again. We also discussed about uniform and non-uniform motion. And we also did a few numericals on average speed and average velocity. Now, continuing the non-uniform motion part of the topic further, we are going to discuss the next physical quantity, which is acceleration. So acceleration means rate of change of velocity. Now rate of change means we are talking the change with respect to time. Change of velocity divided by the time taken for this change to happen. Now change in velocity would mean final value of velocity minus the initial value of velocity divided by the time taken. That is how we are defining acceleration. Rate of change of velocity. Change in velocity divided by time. Change in velocity we are writing as final velocity minus the initial velocity of the object. The symbols that we use here for final velocity and initial velocity are V and U respectively in lowercase, small letters. V and U are representing final and initial velocity respectively. And time will be represented by small t. So acceleration mathematical expression looks like this. It is A is equal to V minus U by t, or the change in velocity divided by the time. So this is how we numerically calculate acceleration. A is V minus U upon t. Now looking at this formula, we can also figure out the SI unit for acceleration. Change in velocity. Velocities will always be taken in meter per second, since that is the SI unit for velocity. So change in velocity would be in meter per second. And time would always be in seconds. So the SI unit for acceleration becomes meter per second square. Or we can also write it as meter per second square. To understand acceleration better, let us start with a simple numerical. It says the velocity of an object changes from 15 meter per second to 25 meter per second in 10 seconds. You have to calculate its acceleration. So the velocity is changing from 15 meter per second. So that means initial velocity is 15 meter per second, and it changes to 25 meter per second. So that means final velocity is 25 meter per second. So following the symbols, U initial velocity is 15 and V final velocity is 25. And this change has taken place in 10 seconds. So, to calculate acceleration, we use the mathematical form which says change in velocity upon time. Change in velocity is written as final minus initial. So, final was 25, initial 15, divided by time 10. When we calculate, we are getting acceleration as 1 meter per second square. So, we can write it either ways, either with this slash division sign or with this negative exponent. Let us consider another example. The velocity of a car increases from 20 meter per second to 25 meter per second in 10 seconds. Calculate its acceleration. So this time the velocity of the car is increasing from 20 meter per second. So initial velocity u is 20 meter per second to 25 meter per second. So that is the final value. V is 25 meter per second. And this change has taken place in 10 seconds. So to calculate acceleration, we use the formula V minus u by t. Putting the values, V as 25 meter per second, u is 20 meter per second, and this change has taken place, t is in 10 seconds. V minus u is 5 divided by 10, which gives us the acceleration as 0.5 meter per second square. So this was another simple numerical which helps us to understand how to calculate acceleration. Now students, by the end of these two examples, we are in a position to understand the meaning of the statement that acceleration of an object is 0.5 meter per second square. Or in the previous example, where acceleration came out to be 1 meter per second square. What do we mean by this statement that the acceleration of the object is 0.5 meter per second square? What is the literal meaning of the statement? It means that the speed of this car is increasing by 0.5 meter per second after every 1 second. What does that mean is, suppose the starting velocity when we started observing the car was say 0.5 meter per second. After 1 second, what will be the velocity be? Since the acceleration is 0.5 meter per second square, it means after every 1 second, the velocity is increasing by 0.5. So after 1 second, the velocity will be 1 meter per second. After the next 1 second, the velocity will be 1.5 meter per second. And the next 1 second, it would be 2 meter per second. So the velocity is increasing by 0.5 meter per second after every 1 second. This is what we mean by acceleration being 0.5 meter per second square. So this is a frequently asked one marker that what do we mean by the statement that acceleration of an object is, say, 2 meter per second square. So how do we answer this question? We write that acceleration being 2 meter per second square means the velocity of the object is increasing by 2 meter per second after every 1 second. So suppose the object starts with 0 velocity. After 1 second, the velocity would be 2 meter per second. After the next 1 second, the velocity would be 4 meter per second. And the next 1 second, it would increase to 6 meter per second. So it increases by 2 meter per second after every 1 second. So acceleration is 2 meter per second square. So this is how we can answer this question. It means velocity of the car increases by 2 meter per second after every 1 second. And we have also given the example which shows the velocity is increasing by 2 meter per second after every 1 second from 0 to 2 to 4 to 6 to 8. In every 1 second, the velocity is increasing by a equal amount of 2 meter per second. Continuing further in the concept, another numerical. A car slows down from 20 meter per second to 10 meter per second. This time the speed is decreasing in 5 seconds by applying brakes. what is its acceleration. So the car has slowed down from 20 meter per second, so initial velocity is 20 meter per second, to 10 meter per second, so final velocity is 10 meter per second, and this change has taken place in 5 seconds by applying brakes. So to calculate acceleration, again we use the same formula, A is V minus U by T, change in velocity upon time. Putting the values, V is 10, U is 20, T is 5. So we get acceleration as minus 10 by 5 or minus 2 meter per second square. This time we have a negative sign since the final velocity is less than the initial velocity here. The car has slowed down. So negative sign here is indicating a decrease in velocity. This is also known as negative acceleration or deceleration. We also call negative acceleration or deceleration as retardation.